Today I'm here to do my 17 week pregnancy update with baby number 3. I didn't update you guys ever since I did a 14 week update. If you guys watched that, that was my first trimester video. And I mentioned in that video that I probably wouldn't be doing weekly updates with this pregnancy, just because I do also do daily vlogs and other videos and it would kind of just be too much. Plus with the daily vlogs, I feel like you guys get a good sense of how I'm doing, how I'm feeling and stuff like that throughout the day. And I feel like not much really goes on week to week. And if it does, then I'll go ahead and update you guys. But most likely it'll probably just be every 2 weeks or maybe every 3 weeks that I update you guys with an actual update like this, where you guys get to see my bump and I'll answer some questions. So I'm gonna go ahead and answer some of these questions that I answered in the last video. I'm just gonna answer these same questions every single time. And then I'll also go over some other information that I have from the doctor and kind of just what's been going on. Actually, so I'm gonna go ahead and just start by saying, if you guys don't know already, we're having a baby girl. We are all so excited about a baby girl. I had a feeling the whole time that it was a baby girl, but part of me was thinking boy, so I still was really shocked when we found out that it was a girl. And I think we do have a name, so be on the lookout for a name reveal coming very soon. Also, we got the great news that everything is healthy with the baby so far. You know, if you guys have been watching us for a while, we had a little bit of a Down syndrome scare with my son when I was pregnant with him. So that's why we got the early genetic testing done where they could tell the gender, and they came back that everything was normal with the baby. One thing that the test did not test for was spina bifida. So on my 17 week appointment, I did get blood work done for that, to check for spina bifida. So we should be knowing within a few days about that result as well. So we're just happy to know that so far, so good, the baby's doing healthy. The baby had a heart rate of 145, I believe, when I was at my 17 week update. And that's kind of all we talked about. We didn't really do anything else. This is the third pregnancy for me, so there are a lot of things that are kind of just normal and kind of just go with the flow. I don't know, there's nothing really else much, which is why I don't really feel like doing the weekly updates. But I'm gonna go ahead and answer these questions so you guys get a better feel of how the last 3 weeks have been for me. Total weight gain. Right now, I am at 10 pounds. Now, I say that because yesterday I was 17 weeks. I stepped on the scale in the morning and it said 10 pounds heavier than when I started. If you guys watched my first video, I actually started this pregnancy 10 pounds heavier than my other two pregnancies, just because I was still trying to lose the baby weight from Jackson's pregnancy. The fact that I'm already 10 pounds heavier than that is kind of freaking me out. But I know I'm at 17 weeks, I'm almost halfway there, and that's just kind of what happens. To go off of that, I did weigh myself again this morning, and it only said 8 pounds heavier. So I'm in between 8 and 10 pounds, somewhere in between there with weight gain. I'm gonna try my best to eat healthier, but I'm not gonna worry too much about it. And also, if you guys watch our daily vlogs, you know that I'm also trying to do a little bit of exercise as well, just for the fact that I don't want to be in too much trouble when it comes to trying to lose weight after my third baby, when this baby comes. Maternity clothes. Yes, I am wearing maternity clothes. I'm also wearing non-maternity clothes. This is actually a little dress that I wore at my wedding rehearsal. Not my rehearsal dinner, but the actual rehearsal at the church. And I'll show it to you guys when I show you my belly. But there are some things that I can still fit into that are not pregnancy or maternity clothes. But I feel most comfortable in maternity clothes at this point. I definitely do have a large belly from what I remember from my last two pregnancies. I think I just kind of popped a lot earlier and we're just kind of growing from there. But I am wearing pregnancy clothes or maternity clothes. And on that note, I am going to be doing a collaboration with Pink Blush Maternity, and they have sent me some clothes that I absolutely love. So I'm going to be doing a video soon for you guys about those clothes that they sent me. And also, they're going to be giving away a $50 gift card. So be on the lookout for that video if you guys want to win a $50 gift card to Pink Blush Maternity or Pink Blush. They also do a non-maternity section as well. Stretch marks. No stretch marks yet, but like I said in my last video, I'm a little bit nervous about stretch marks this time just because I did start the pregnancy a little bit heavier than the other two. I don't know if my belly's gonna stretch further or what's gonna happen there, but I'm crossing my fingers for no stretch marks. I didn't have any stretch marks with the last two, so if it's a hereditary thing, I probably won't get them, but you never know. Sleep. Sleep is good. I'm still sleeping well. I can still sleep on my belly most nights. I'm trying to find some good positions, but nothing to where it's like waking me up in the middle of the night. I'm not really having to get up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom too much either, so sleep is good so far. Best moment of the week. I'm gonna go back 3 weeks. Best moment of the last 3 weeks is definitely finding out that we're having a baby girl and definitely finding out that the baby girl is healthy so far. That was one thing that I was just super worried about just because of our last experience. It really was traumatizing and stressful. So just to find out that she's healthy so far was awesome. Do I miss anything? Probably the same thing as last time. I definitely miss turkey subs and subs in general. I miss sushi, which I don't normally eat a lot of sushi, but for some reason I've wanted sushi, like the good kind with the raw fish. And what else do I miss? I think that's it. Movement. This is a good question. I started feeling Jane move, I think at like 18 weeks. With Jackson, I think I started feeling him at 15 weeks. And this time, I still don't know if I feel her. I know what to feel for, and I swear I've felt her a few times. And I'm 17 weeks now, and the doctor said that maybe my placenta is in front, so it's kind of making a barrier so I can't really feel her kicking. I'm gonna go ahead and say yes, I've felt her a few times. I swear I've felt her. There have been a few times where I've felt a kick, and then I would like be really still and try to feel another one, and then nothing. So nothing to where I'm like, oh yeah, that's a kick. But definitely, I'm gonna go ahead and say yes, I have, and it's great. Food cravings. Yeah, which is probably why I've gained 10 pounds. If you guys watch my daily vlogs, I craved Krispy Kreme, I craved Mexican, like white queso, I'm craving pickles, and I think that's pretty much it as far as cravings. There's a lot of random cravings where all of a sudden I want something, and I just kind of go for it, but those are the main three things right now. It was spicy things and pizza in the first trimester, but it's kind of changed over a little bit. Anything making you queasy or sick? So I'm definitely feeling a lot better than I was the first trimester. My energy has come backs kind of. I'm still taking care of a 9-month-old and a 3-year-old, so I'm pretty sure my energy is not going to come back full force or anything. I'm getting a few bloody noses, which is really gross, but I had bloody noses with Jane and I didn't have any with Jackson, so that's kind of a weird comparison with the girl pregnancies and the boy pregnancy. I don't know, I'm feeling good, I'm feeling fine. Nothing's really making me sick. I'm definitely taking another iron pill along with my prenatal because I was feeling really tired and like no energy whatsoever. And that's really helped, but it also makes me feel a little bit nauseous even if I eat it with food. So sometimes I get nauseous from that. But other than that, I'm doing good, I'm hanging in there. If you guys have been watching me for a while, you know that towards the end of Jackson's pregnancy, I had a really bad ligament pain. I don't know if it was round ligament. According to the doctor, it wasn't, but it was a horrible pain, which is another reason why I asked to be induced at 39 weeks with Jackson. And it's back. It's back and it's with a vengeance. It does not hurt when I'm sitting or laying down, so that's the good thing. If it's really hurting, I can just sit or lay down and it goes away. But when I'm walking or standing, it hurts. And I think that it's hurting a lot more early this time. One, because the two pregnancies were really close together, and two, because I'm just heavier than I was in the last pregnancy at this point. So that kind of stinks, because I'm only 17 weeks and it's already hurting and I know that it's not gonna go away. There's nothing I can really do, so I'm just kind of going with it. Have you started to show yet? Yes, and I'll show you guys my belly in just a second. Gender, it's a girl, and we're excited. Labor signs, no labor signs, thank goodness. My belly button is in, but I'm gonna call it a flatty because it's not all the way in like it normally is, but it's not popped out yet. And that's another thing that's kind of happened a lot earlier than my other two pregnancies. I feel like it's gonna pop real soon. And I feel like in my other pregnancies, it didn't pop till like 30 weeks or so. Is my wedding ring on or off? It's on, but it's getting tight. And that's another thing. I think just because I started this pregnancy heavier, I feel like I'm gonna have to take it off soon. And with my other pregnancies, it wasn't until like 30 weeks that I had to take it off, or 32 weeks. So we'll see how much longer I can keep this thing on, but I'm trying to keep it on as long as I can. Happy or moody most of the time? Most of the time these days, I'm happy. I'm glad I'm feeling better. I'm glad I have my energy back. I'm glad to know it's a girl and that she's healthy. And it's just fun to kind of plan for the future. So I would say mostly happy. And what I'm looking forward to is finding out if she's okay with spina bifida. And also at 21 weeks, we are getting our anatomy scan. Usually you do it at 20 weeks, but my office only does ultrasounds on Wednesdays, and they are busy on the Wednesday of my 20 weeks. So I think it's like the first day, either March 2nd or March 3rd, we're gonna be having our ultrasound, and we get to see the baby girl we haven't seen in a long time. I think it was like 8 weeks the last time we saw her on the ultrasound. So it'll be really exciting for that. I think we're gonna take Jane and Jackson with us because Chris wants to be there for that. So that is really exciting, something I'm looking forward to. Another thing that's kind of off topic is I'm looking forward to Chris's birthday, which is this Sunday. I'm looking forward to Super Bowl, which is this Sunday. I'm looking forward to Valentine's Day. There's just a lot of fun things going on this month. So stay tuned. That is it for my update. I'm gonna show you guys my belly and then I'm gonna go. All right, so this is the dress that I wore for my rehearsal. Like I said, you can't really see how long it is, but here's my 17 week belly. I don't know if you can see that good. I'm not wearing maternity pants, but I'll show you how. Here's my belly. See how my belly button's almost popped out. I hope you guys liked this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye.